I'm Jeff Davis. I'm on the Postgres team at Microsoft, and I'm also a Postgres committer. We're introducing a new Columnar feature to Citus 10 that's going to bring Columnar storage to Postgres. If you haven't heard of Citus, Citus is a Postgres extension, totally open source. It's not a fork, and it turns Postgres into a distributed database system. And then with version 10, we're actually going beyond that, incorporating features like Columnar that just enhance Postgres overall. What is Columnar? Columnar is a storage strategy that groups data together by columns rather than rows. So when the data is organized in the storage system, then it puts all the data from the same column together. And then that way, as we'll see later, you can actually just skip over columns you don't need. You can use Columnar without taking advantage of all the Citus scale-up features. You can also use it on single node Citus, which is new in version 10 that allows you to have a single node that's all ready to scale out as soon as you need to by distributing the tables. You can also use it as part of a whole Citus cluster on a multi-node system and take advantage of Columnar in that system as well. So I'm going to show off first just really the absolute basics, you know, how to create a Columnar table. And then going to show a little bit about the performance characteristics using a contrived workload, just to show off the benefits that you can see out of Columnar. And then I'm going to show something a little bit closer to how you'd actually want to use Columnar, which is along with range partitioning. It really works well with that feature as kind of a way to balance the benefits of row tables and columnar tables in the same system. I've installed Postgres 13 along with Citus 10 here. I've also got this clipboard manager to help me paste the demo commands, so you'll see this box pop up occasionally. Like any Postgres extension, we've got to create the extension first. So it's already enabled in this database because I've preloaded some columnar data for the demo. I'm going to create a simple table. So you can see here, this is a non-columnar table, and I'm just going to use the psql describe command, which is backslash d plus. I'm doing this just to show the access method. So here, the access method is heap, indicating it's an ordinary Postgres table that's got row-based storage. Now, I'm going to create a columnar table. The only thing we have to do is just add this using columnar syntax, and the table is columnar. So let's go ahead and create that one, and then we'll describe this table. We can see here that the access method is columnar. Now, let's do a few simple interactions with it. We're going to insert a single tuple and select from it. So you can see that it acts just like a row table. Now let's get to the interesting part. We're going to do some performance comparisons and size comparisons. So I preloaded a table with 75 million tuples. This is a wide table, about 600 bytes per tuple. So this is really ideal for columnar queries, and we're going to take a look at what we get. First, we're going to take a look at the size of the row table. It's called perf row. You can see here it's 44 gigabytes. Then we're going to take a look at the columnar table. We can see it's only 8 gigabytes. If we just divide those numbers, you can see that that's better than a 5x compression ratio. That's already good. That's going to save on I/O and storage costs and all that. The next thing I'm going to do is run this query here. This is a group by query. The offset clause, this just helps us ignore the output. And the group by clause, that's just, it is a simple group by query. So we'll see how long this takes to run. This is running against the row table. So this is going to take a while. I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead so we don't have to wait for it. As you can see, this query took over 7 minutes to execute. we're going to run the same query against the columnar table now. And we can see it's only picking up a couple of columns here. So it's going to be able to skip over those unneeded columns. And in addition to the compression, these two things will compound. This is a wide row table, so skipping over those columns is really important. And we're going to see this query return a lot faster. In fact, we didn't even need to skip ahead. It only took about 16 seconds. And so that's something like a 20x speedup, which is just a dramatic difference. So for these types of things, columnar just is dramatically more efficient, dramatically faster. So now I'll show an important use case for columnar, which is when you combine it with range partitioning. And this is important because you can combine row and columnar tables together. So range partitioning allows you to take one logical table and break it up into smaller partitions based on ranges. And these are usually time ranges. They don't have to be, but they're usually time ranges. So here we're going to see one overall events table. And this is the partition table. It doesn't actually hold any data. The data is held in these partitions. So here we have a partition for January and a partition for February. You may want to mix columnar partitions and row partitions in the same table. Columnar tables and columnar partitions can't be updated, while row partitions can. So what you can do is you can have the older partitions, in this case January, as we'll see in the demo, we're going to convert that to columnar, and that's going to benefit from the compression and the increased scan speed. While February, we'll leave that as a row table because that's more recent and that may still need updates, and that's going to benefit from the updates still. And then we're going to be able to look at all of this data together through one logical parent table. Let's take a look at this in the demo. Going to start off creating the parent events table. Here we have the events table partitioned by timestamp. This isn't going to hold any actual data. We need to create some partitions to do that. So we're going to create the January partition. That's the name. It can be accessed directly or through the parent table. Ordinarily, you'd access it through the parent table. Here's the range part of the range partition. It describes the month of January. And then we're going to do the same for February with the range that describes February. Notice with partitioning, the last piece is exclusive. And then also notice both of these, we didn't specify any using clause, so these are going to default to the ordinary Postgres tables, which are row-based storage. Now we're going to load some data. It's loading 100,000 tuples. Let's convert the older January partition to columnar. We're going to use this built-in, Citus provided function here to do the conversion. That comes along with Citus and allows you to alter the table access method from row to columnar or the other direction. And so it did a few things here. And then now if we look at it, if we look at the January partition, we can see that now that has access method columnar, while the February partition still has access method heap, indicating that it's an ordinary Postgres row table. So now the older January partition will benefit from the compression and scan speed benefits of columnar, while the newer February partition can still be updated. So as you convert more and more of the partitions to columnar as time goes on, then a larger share of the data will be in columnar. And typically you'd only leave the last partition or two to be still updated, and those would still be row partitions. And then we can see here now that you can still access all the data from the parent table. So I've just showed how you can create a partition table, load some data, and then convert the row partitions that don't need updates anymore, convert those to columnar, and then benefit from the additional compression and scan speed you get with columnar. Columnar enhances and complements a lot of the existing Citus use cases, which are things like customer-facing analytics dashboards, time series, multi-tenant SaaS apps, and then mixed transactional and analytic workloads. If you've used CStore FDW, that's an earlier project, and you can think of Citus Columnar as the next generation of that. Citus Columnar is just much better integrated and just overall more complete as a feature and a system. And the reason it's able to do that is because of the new internal Postgres API. It's like an extension API that allows you to integrate more tightly. This is called the Table Access Method API. And that just provides a lot better integration with other Postgres features. So Citus Columnar is going to work well with write-ahead log, crash recovery, physical replication, PG upgrade. And so it's just a more complete feature. From a technical standpoint, the benefits of Citus Columnar come from two places, really. The first, compression, that you know, those columns being stored together compress better. And then also, you know, on top of the compression, you have the ability to then skip over the columns you don't need. That's doubly reducing the I/O needed to answer an analytic query. And then, you know, along the way, of course, that provides the more business benefits of just faster query response, which can help meet SLAs. Overall, better efficiency, you know, lower storage requirements, lower cost for I/O systems, and that kind of thing. There's more work to do with Columnar. We don't yet have support for updates or deletes. We don't have yet support for indexes, and we don't yet have support for logical replication. Citus Columnar is the first fully integrated Columnar feature for Postgres, and it's available as a part of Citus 10. Columnar is fully open source as part of the same GitHub repo, so check it out here. Please file issues, pull requests, and participate. You can get Citus Columnar by downloading Citus from GitHub and compiling it yourself. Just make sure that you're using at least Postgres version 12 and Citus version 10, and then you'll have Columnar. That's the way I like to do things, but if you prefer, you can get operating system packages, or you can go on Azure. There's under the Azure database for PostgreSQL hyperscale Citus, choose the hyperscale Citus option there. Make sure you're getting at least Citus 10, and you'll have Columnar. Here's the list of ways you can reach us. You know, GitHub is my favorite, but there's Slack, there's the email newsletter, has a lot of important announcements. So go ahead and join, you know, look into these, and I look forward to hearing from you.